What did you eat today? Let me guess. Perhaps there were some potatoes, or perhaps some tomatoes. Or there might have been some rice, or might have been some wheat. Well, it's not that hard to guess after all, because 75% of world's food comes from just 12 plants and 5 animals. On the other hand, there are 30,000 different plants that we can eat. Let's take this wild fig, for example. This is really delicious and nutritious, and it grows all around India. And in spite of that, very few people eat it. I grew up in rural India with so many amazing memories of food. When I was a child, I used to sit under this huge banyan tree in early summer morning with some of my friends. From home, we brought mango, tamarind, and we added some salt and some chili. And the taste, it's still stuck in my mouth. Not only that, we had different kinds of fruits, berries growing all around the year. Wood apple, wild jujube, figs, will be to name a few. This was the time I really fell in love with nature. And this love slowly started fading away when I had to move away from my village. I was living in different parts of India for my high studies. Eventually, I moved to Sweden. Life in Sweden was completely different in many ways. For the first time, I was cooking food. During that time, one day my partner asked me, "Biman, why don't you track the source of your food?" I thought, okay, that seems like an interesting exercise. So I started doing that. And what I found out started really shocking me. I found out the avocado that I was eating was coming from Peru, the chili from Mexico, pineapple from Costa Rica. I realized not only these foods were coming from very far away, the way they are being produced is causing a lot of environmental destruction. Until that point, I thought I'm someone who really cares about environment because I was doing my recycling, right? I was going to university by bicycle. But at that moment, finding all this thing out, well, I realized I'm just an average consumer. I hated this fact, and I really wanted to change that. So I started growing some of my own food in my backyard. I created a kitchen garden. I started going to forest for foraging different kinds of fruits, berries, and nuts. Food once again put me back in touch with nature. And a lot of childhood memories started coming back. So I felt a bit homesick, and I went back home. Going back home, this time I was paying close attention to the surroundings around me, what was there. And what I found was really upsetting. The banyan tree is not there anymore. It has been replaced by plants like eucalyptus and acacia. All these fruits, berries, and nuts that you once ate are gone. The birds that I saw flew in the sky, like vulture, falcon, we don't see them anymore. I realized the food diversity has gone down quite a lot. My mother, she used to cook at least 15 different varieties of wild greens. These days, she barely finds any. So it's not only the food that is going away, the knowledge along with we are losing too. My generation will barely know any of these two or three of these greens. The culture is also at high risk. When I was a kid, we used to have this rice harvesting festival where the whole community will come together and cook different sort of rice, and we had a lot of fun. We stopped celebrating that as well. So I dug deeper, like what's going on here? And what I found out is this. This is industrial agriculture which is driving this change. It promotes heavy pesticides, chemical pesticide, fertilizer, lot of uses of hybrid seeds, lot of water, and heavy machineries. Right now, we are standing in the face of climate change. Along with all this problem, it makes us really vulnerable to our food security. Once I realized all this, I decided, okay, enough of computer science. By the way, if I forgot to mention, I was in Sweden for PhD in computer science. I am not sure if I saw that. So I thought, okay, enough of that. I want to come back and work in back home with nature. And that's how the idea of bon was born. Bon in my mother tongue means forest. When you think of forest, it reminds us of huge diversity of life. And that's exactly what Bon wants to do. We want to bring back diversity of life to our farmland. And to do that, we have a few strategies. First, we make people aware that there are diverse food, like for this wild fig, for example. Second, when people know that there are diverse food, we'll create different mouth-watering recipes with all this food that we'll have. By the way, if you have not tried this fig, please do try that. It tastes somewhat similar to plantain, if you have eaten plantain, but I guarantee you this is much better than plantain. Third, once people know that there are diverse food and demanding for this diverse food, that's what it will grow in our farmland. And to implement this, we have four stages. Family kitchen garden. So right now what's happening is that farmers are completely dependent on the market. In my village, people are selling different kind of rice, or actually only hybrid rice, and everything else, all other food products they buy from the market, for example, vegetables. To change that, we'll work with these families to create kitchen garden in their backyard. So next time, when they need food or vegetables, they don't need to go back to the market. They can always run back to their backyard and get whatever they please to. A second is food diversity back to the farmland. So right now, farmers are only farming hybrid rice twice a year. And we will work with the farmers again to change this with different kind of indigenous rice, millets, and sesame, and a lot more of these indigenous varieties. This will make sure that in the face of climate change, if something fails, there will be some other crops which will survive. And in fact, they can thrive as well in this changing climate. Third, food forest. A food forest is a man-made forest. I would rather say it's a man-managed forest. So it looks exactly like forest, but it's primarily being used for producing different kind of fruits, berries, herbs, spices, and a lot more. Fourth is value addition. All these products that will be growing with all these three methods, instead of selling them directly in the market, we will work with farmers again to process this food in a different ways: jam, jelly, dried herbs, spices, and so on. This will make sure the farmers have a stable income no matter what is happening. 5 years from now, we see at least 500 families are farming this way. These families also understand that farming and nature can go together if we know how to work with nature. And these families will become the pioneer who will take this movement forward. Food diversity plays a very important role in what Bon wants to do. So now, let's hear some food facts.
Food facts. Number one, rice. There are roughly 6,000 varieties of rice still found in India. We know of basmati as the only aromatic rice, but there are around 300 more. For example, Gobindabhog, which has sweet, buttery taste. There is indigenous rice available in different colors like red, white, brown, and black. Number 2. Potatoes. Have you ever tried a purple potato? These potatoes are dry and known for their antioxidant properties. Apart from what we normally see in our kitchen, there are 4,000 varieties of potatoes available in color, shape, and sizes. Number 3. Tomatoes. Did you know that tomatoes and potatoes come from the same family? No wonder they sound similar. There are 3,000 varieties of tomatoes, which are sweet, savory, and sour. And they come in interesting colors like black, purple, yellow, orange, and green. Number 4. Turmeric. Are you thinking of the yellow spice powder? But I am talking about black turmeric. It has a pungent smell. It is somewhat bitter with an earthy, hot taste. Ooh. Like yellow turmeric, it's also known for its anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties.
protection of environment, specifically biodiversity, is Bond's utmost priority. And to do that, we will use diverse food as a connector between people and nature. Thank you.